often, when you record audio, you can pick up room or background noise. This video will show you one technique to fix this and optimize your audio. You can see in this example that room noise is existing right here in this range. Let's play this so you can hear it. So let's see what this captures. So you can see it's picking up a little bit of fan or air conditioner noise from the room. It always helps to record some room tone. In this case, I just did that in the middle of my audio. Make it part of your workflow. When you're out doing video or recording an interview, capture some of that room tone either at the beginning or end or independently. So our first step is to take this into Adobe Audition. So we're just going to right click, and then we have the option to edit this clip in Adobe Audition. If this option is grayed out, you may need to either update Premiere or Audition, and it also helps to have Audition open when you do this. So in Audition, we're going to select our room noise, and that's this part right here. So I'm just going to click and select with my time selection tool. Next, I'll go up to Effects, Noise Reduction, and Capture Noise Print. And we'll hit OK. Now we want to deselect that clip just by clicking down, and then we can select all of the audio. And I just used Command A. Now we'll apply that by going to the same place, Effect, Noise Reduction, and this time we'll do Noise Reduction Process. So in this dialog box, we're going to want to work with the Noise Reduction and the Reduce By. The Noise Reduction controls the percentage of noise reduction. Fine-tuning this setting while watching those audio levels will achieve excellent noise reduction with minimal artifacts. If you get too aggressive with this, the audio is going to sound a little off. Right below that is the Reduce By. This determines the amplitude reduction of that noise. So if you recall from our video, that was falling around 30. So we're going to kind of keep that in mind. I'm really liking right around 60, and let's just move that up to almost 20, and we'll hit apply, and you can see we've removed most of that artifact. And we can preview here, but if we want to go ahead and work in Premiere, all we need to do is save this clip, and when we jump over to Premiere, you can see it just automatically updated for us. And so that applied to all of the audio. So you can definitely see it in this area, but it helped all of our audio throughout.
Movement. So let's see what this captures.
So the overall audio is so much clearer. So give that technique a try and see if that helps with some background noise and other room tone you might pick up.